have vanished from around 95% of their previous range, and they have gone extinct in about 26 African countries. Interactions happen very often, and when they do happen, it's very negative. So the lions would end up killing the livestock of these communities, or they would kill or injure people. Then the community retaliates by killing the lion, which is justified because they would have encountered a loss. So far, land conservation has been mainly done by people who are coming from other countries, especially the West, and that has been having an effect. But I think the direction which we should take now is for conservation in Africa to be led by the local communities, by the local people. And in that way, the people most affected, if they are at the forefront of the conservation of these lions, then we will start to see a change. What we are doing at the moment in Nyaminyam communal lands is we recruited a team of community guardians. They live with the community, they are part of the community. We call them Vatavilili in Tonga, which means the protectors, because that's their job, to protect both the community and the lions. They assess the livestock crows of these households, and when a crow is weak, they can show them how to strengthen the crow so that it is predator proof. They also monitor the movements of lions, so that if there is a lion in one area, they can tell the community to say, no, don't go to this area. Because when the conflict doesn't happen, then it means that there is no retaliatory killing of lions by the community. We are starting to see an increase in the number of people who are reporting when they see a footprint of an animal. Before that, people were not even reporting when an incident happened, because they felt like the authorities and other people did not care much about what happens to them, and they only cared about the wildlife. I am very optimistic. The efforts that we are doing right now will ensure that the lions will be there in 50 years' time.